today I want to talk about shadow side of stuff a little bit and loving your shadow. This is a little disclaimer here. I'm only sharing my experiences with things and hopefully they're helpful to you. I'm not registered as anything, like not psychologist, spiritual counselor, nothing. I just really get inspired and empowered and makes me really work on my self-help journey when I hear other people's stories, regardless of what they are. So I'm hoping that by sharing mine, you guys can kind of get something else out of it, hopefully, I guess. But when I talk about my shadow work journey, which is in a previous video, I mentioned always sitting down with an aspect of my shadow self that I named Jeffrey. And I say I have tea with him. I sit down and have conversations with him. It's kind of like a way to bounce ideas off of myself of like what is really going on with me. And with that, what I think I kind of left out of that video is how I was basically learning to love the sides of myself that I saw as distasteful. And I think this is really, really an empowering thing to do, especially because, you know, so many times we look at ourselves and we're just hypercritical. And when you're doing shadow work and all of that, I think there can be, at least for me, the instinct was to find a way to take these things and kill them, or take away, personify them, and then cast them out of my life so they would no longer be an issue type of deal. And as I've gone on, I have definitely realized that shadow work is much more of an ongoing thing. Like, it is a journey. It is not going to be something where you're like, bing, bang, boom, I did it, now I'm done. I've moved on with my life. Like, now I'm a great embodied person and I know exactly what to do. It's much more of a journey when something gets dredged up and then something else gets dredged up and then something else gets dredged up and then you have to go back and re-dredge up their first thing you were dredging up because it's brought up a whole new bunch of different issues. And it can be really hard at times to face yourself and not suddenly go down like a self-loathing like spiral and believe that by facing all these things and realizing all these things about yourself, that it's not actually good at all. And so it took me a little while to realize that I wasn't going to be casting out these aspects at all. It was bringing them in a way, even bringing them closer and finding the benefit of them and finding the parts of them that really actually aid me as a person and really actually really like about myself now, as opposed to casting them all aside for nothing. Like for me, for example, one of the things that really got me is I am, in a way, almost like negligible to my faults, to a fault, if that makes sense. Like I never see myself as the problem. It was something that I developed younger as a defense mechanism against a mix of bullies and other things that were going on in my life. And this got me into a lot of trouble. When I really started to dive into shadow work again, I had to sit down and personify the bad parts of myself because I honestly could not look at myself and say that there was something wrong with me. By doing that, it felt like I was going after my own soul. It felt like I was going to go down this self-hatred spiral. I had seen people around me do that, where they were just so self-deprecating and so much self-hatred. And I did not want to cause that in myself. And I didn't really know what the trigger was or how that could happen in other people. So I was so protective of, no, there's nothing wrong with me. There's nothing wrong with me. And I had to sit down and really go, no, there is stuff wrong with you. And you have to address that and fix that. Otherwise, how the hell are you supposed to grow as a person? So with that, though, completely casting aside the idea that there is nothing wrong with me or that defense that I have where I always put it on the other person does not serve me. I had to learn to actually really love that part about myself because it did. It protected me a lot in middle school and high school, where everyone else around me, I could feel like I still were affected by people. Like things still like really affected me if they said, oh, well, you're an ugly brat. Like I still took that on and was like, oh, am I an ugly brat? And I had to like, that moment still happened. But around 10 to 15 minutes later or the next day or something, the thing that would kick in is go, of course you're not a brat. That's not you. Like that's them. And I could defend against a lot of people who were just trying to be cruel. And that was really helpful for that time. That's what I needed in that moment, is to go, no, you don't have to take on everyone else's opinion. And I learned that really young, really quick. And that is a really great tool for me to use. But it does have a negative side of it. It is a double-edged sword. It really helps me to cut away bullshit when bullshit's coming at me, but it also makes me have to, now to really improve myself, I have to constantly check in with myself. That instinct I keep there is the first thing, because I do think that there is a shit ton of bullshit out there, and you kind of have to put your wall up, at least for me, to be like, no, that's not serving me at all. But there are definitely times from other people that I care about where I didn't acknowledge it before and now I need to, is that I'm like, no, you are at fault sometimes. There was something, even if what they said was cruel or mean, there's some truth to what they said and you should look at that and address it. But by loving that part of myself, I can still see it as a useful tool versus realizing that, oh, that doesn't work all the time and now I'm never going to use it. And then it's the overcorrection that I would have overcorrected and taken on everyone's criticism. So sitting down with myself and loving that part of myself that is so defensive and going, you are so helpful and you helped me so much and I thank you with all of my heart for that, allows me to also then check myself and go, but you are not the tool that I need right now. With my shadow self, Jeffrey in particular, it was a very using anger as a way to solve my problems. It's not always necessarily a good thing, very clearly. Like, violence is not the answer. Anger is not always the answer. It doesn't always communicate well with what you want. But to disregard that anger entirely and not see it as the useful tool it is with really expressing myself and getting things across, anger is a very useful tool. It's a palpable tool and it's not something to disregard entirely. I don't want to be a person who's never angry ever again. I like that anger, which is, I guess, a weird thing to say, but I found that when I've come into tune into loving that part of myself, it really, really helped. That's something I really hope that everyone to do, because honestly, the real start of my self-love journey where I felt that I was really making leaps and bounds was when I learned to love my demons and basically look at myself and realize that even with everyone else with their stipulations and like lines that they could cross, there is a line with myself that I can never actually ever cross. I love myself unconditionally. All aspects of myself. The good, the bad, the demons, the whatever, like the shadows, the in-between, the grays, all of that stuff I take in fully. And I recognize it fully. It's not, loving it is not excusing it. It still is addressing it, but going, you know what? You did the thing. It kind of sucked, but I still love you. Anyway, I just want to come on and talk about that a little with you guys since I felt it was kind of missing from my shadow work journey video. But there are new videos that I do every Wednesday and Saturday. So I will see you guys next time.